neighborhood eyesores. Just one of the concerns from Omaha citizens tonight, the public's first chance to weigh in on the mayor's budget. And the debate goes far beyond the controversial raises that Jim Suttle handed out. Good evening, I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Melissa Fryan for Brandy Peterson. Now, some did criticize the mayor at tonight's public forum.
This after the city council sent its own message today, a unanimous vote giving the mayor a legislative slap on the wrist.
These increases, a 20% increase, an 18% increase, and I don't care if it's only to one person or two person, sends the wrong message to our fellow citizens.
The mayor says he did not mean to deceive anyone, and we should note his budget does not include any new taxes.
But we still heard plenty of concern on other issues tonight. KTV News Watch 7's Jeremy Maskell joins us live at City Hall with our big story.
And Melissa, much of that concern is over money, how much may come in the coming year. But some want the city to spend more on certain projects to build a better community.
Hours after a meeting with plenty of council comment, Omaha city leaders listened at a 2013 budget hearing. Concern over staff raises came up again.
This budget is irresponsible, particularly because of selective, bloated pay increases.
Many sported stickers handed out by Nebraska Taxpayers for Freedom. But talk quickly turned to issues like vacant homes and empty lots.
These homes cause property values to decline and cause our families to flee older neighborhoods.
It prevents people from going outside in their neighborhoods because of the eyesore of what they see.
The North Omaha Neighborhood Alliance asked for more money to demolish those homes.
I'm hopeful that it won't get lost in the shuffle because I think it's such a priority. Then when we talk about the city as a whole, when we talk about neighborhoods, when we talk about safety, when we talk about crime, when we talk about violence, all that goes back and is connected to dilapidated housing.
And after a banner year for Omaha attractions, others asked for help promoting the city using more tax revenue generated by hotels and restaurants.
We have invested in new hotels, attractions, ballpark, convention center, and we need to get new tourists and conventions to our city.
And even as politics heat up this fall, the council says this is business.
And we would all be doing that whether we were running for re-election or not, because that's our job.
What kind of a city do we want? I mean, do we want to grow up as a city? And if we do, it's going to take money to do that.
Now, the council will review the mayor's budget proposals and vote on the matter August 28th. Again, the proposals include no new taxes. Reporting live at City Hall, Jeremy Maskell, KETV, News Watch 7.